Shifting our focus now, the political turmoil in Haiti continues. A country that was already in crisis was brought to its knees when President Jovenel Moïse was killed. Since his killing, Prime Minister Ariel Henry has taken charge of the government, but that is pushing Haiti's political situation towards greater turmoil here. The latest coming in, Prime Minister Henry has sacked the Justice Minister, making the Interior Minister in charge of both of these ministries now.
Nous vivons des temps difficiles avec des besoins pressants de justice et de sécurité. Justice pour tous ceux qui sont assassinés, notamment le président de la République, son Excellence Jovenel Moïse, le bâtonnier Dorval, les journalistes et bien d'autres citoyennes et citoyens. Justice dans le cadre de la lutte contre la corruption. Justice pour tous ceux qui sont en prison pour toutes sortes de raisons.
The decision comes just 1 week after new evidence against Prime Minister Henry was unearthed. Main suspect in this investigation is a Justice Ministry official. It is being said that he ordered to kill the president. And latest phone records show that Prime Minister spoke to the main suspect twice just hours before Moïse was shot dead. It's been 3 months of utter chaos in Port-au-Prince, but the investigation took a dramatic turn last week when prosecutor Bed Claude sent a letter to Prime Minister Henry asking to discuss the phone records. The Justice Minister, who has been now sacked, was backing prosecutors to seek charges against the Prime Minister, but both Justice Minister and primary prosecutors have been replaced this week. The government is in disarray after another senior official resigned, saying that he would not work under a prime minister who's being suspected of murder of the president. The prime minister has rejected all these allegations, and on July 7th, heavily armed assassins stormed into Jovenel Moïse's private residence and shot him dead and injured his wife as well. Police say they have arrested 44 people so far, including 18 former Colombian soldiers.